just imagine your most vivid memory? Is it real or just a figment of your imagination? What if I told you that your mind can construct memories so convincing that it can shape your reality? Dive in with me as we peel back the layers of our minds, exploring the mysterious world of false memory syndrome. Prepare to question everything you thought you knew about your reality.
So please tell me I'm sleeping. Tell me I'm sleeping. Pinch me to kill.
Welcome to a kingdom of our mind where the boundaries of reality are limitless, the past can be rewritten, and where your deepest memories may betray you. We are about to dive into the maze of our mind to analyze a phenomenon that reveals the malleability of memory, the false memory syndrome. Dr. Elizabeth Loftus is an American psychologist best known for her work on the misinformation effect, false memory, and criticism of recovered memory therapies. Her research illuminated the shocking truth that memories, the precious archive of our lives, are susceptible to modification. Our brains, parallel to filmmakers, can modify our past experiences, creating a story so convincing that it can challenge our understanding of our reality. Plato wrote that learning is simply a process of recollection. So, can our mind be seen as an echoing chamber of information, susceptible to distortion and reinterpretation? If so, can we truly trust our memories as accurate writers of our past? Or are we potential prisoners in our cognitive illusions, navigating through an intricate maze of our imaginations and fantasies? Is what happened to our past real, or what we created for ourselves to be real? Consider the flashbulb memories, those vivid snapshots of important events that are believed to be unfadable. Coined by psychologist Roger Brown and social scientist James Kulik, this concept challenges our understanding of memory retention. It's a revelation that even these imprints are susceptible to the same reconstructive processes that give birth to false memories. But that's not all. Memories aren't just susceptible to distortion, they're continuously evolving. Eric Kandel, a Nobel laureate, proved that remembering can reshape our neuron structures and functions. Imagine our memories not as indelible imprints, but as ever-changing sand mandalas, exquisitely vulnerable to our brain's shifting dynamics. To illustrate this, think of the Mandela effect, the phenomenon of collective misremembering. This effect is a testament to the overwhelming power of collective memory distortions. Each misrecollection, each warped memory, fades the line between reality and perception, relentlessly challenging the trust we place in our personal and shared histories. So as we dive deeper into the landscape of uncertainty, we are left to wonder the complex battle between perception and reality. How can we truly trust our memories? Let's step into our minds where you are the sole designer of your reality, capable of molding reality to mirror your deepest desires. The key to unlock this power lies within you, to shape, reform, and reconstruct not only your past but your future. Quantum physicist John Wheeler revolutionized our understanding of reality through his delayed choice experiment, suggesting that our observations can influence past events. It's a startling idea, evoking the possibility of conscious observation as an instrument for altering our reality. Richard Davidson's research on neuroplasticity also illuminated how our mind is reshapable. Davidson demonstrated how training our mind through meditation can reshape our brain, demonstrating that our thoughts and perceptions can influence our physical reality. Carl Pregram's holographic brain theory proposes that our brain creates a holographic representation of the world, contributing to our perception of reality. If our brains is crafting these holograms, then it clearly suggests we can influence our reality by adjusting these internal projections. According to geneticist Bruce Lipton, our beliefs can even alter our biology. He suggests positive thinking can bring positive physical modification, reinforcing the mind-body connection. Albert Bandura's theory of self-efficacy also reveals how our confidence in our abilities can impact our reality. His research supports that our capacity to achieve our goals can fundamentally change our lives. Immanuel Kant's theory suggests that we experience the world not as it is but as we perceive it. Reality, in this view, becomes inherently subjective, bound to our interpretations and perceptions. Physicist Max Planck wrote, "I regard consciousness as fundamental. I regard matter as derivative from consciousness. We cannot get behind consciousness. Everything that we talk about, everything that we regard as existing, postulates consciousness. These words support the concept that our conscious mind holds the key to our reality, navigating the perception of reality, and therefore our life's course. This exploration reveals a shapeable reality ready to bend to our perceptions, beliefs, and desires. Each discovery highlights the latent power we possess to reshape our world, inviting us to reimagine our life's trajectory. Perception is the paintbrush of reality. Every thought, every belief, every memory holds the power to sketch a new path. The canvas of our lives is never truly complete. It is a beautiful work in progress, guided by the master artist within us all. So, dare to reimagine, dare to rewrite, and dare to reshape, for your mind is the sculptor of your world.